Hello everybody, welcome back to Divinity, Original Sin, the Enhanced Edition. Welcome back, yes. As you can see, the barrier's down, and these enemies here have been defeated. I have done this video once before, including defeating Boreas, and going to the Elemental Forge, and turning the staff in, and getting his siblings out. And then my PC decided to crash and it corrupted the file. So I had to do it all again. So I've gone back to the save after defeating these ice elementals. I don't think they're too important, are they? But I will do the Boreas fight again. Well, this should be fun. Alright folks, here we go. Alright, in we go, straight away. Come on.
There thou art! The upstart that seeketh to upset the harmony of Heimerheim. Why hast thou ventured here, Avatar of Man? Why dost thou seek the downfall of Lord, nay, King Boreas, Sovereign of Winter?
Just give me a sec while I set my men up, and then I'll talk to you. There we go. I guess I just hit snow.
Huh? 'Tis a pity thou dost, intruder. For thou shalt spend eternity in ice, a guest in Hotel Heimerheim forever.
Hotel Heimerheim. So tell me, Boreas, what is it you have done to this realm of fairy?
Fairy! I have marcheth to the gallows, Heimerheim drawn forth from freeze and frost. How they mocketh me, my brother seasons! Thou art the ugliest quarter, they sayeth to my frozen face. Thou art the blemish of the year. Fool that thou art, my brothers! Winter is the jewel of the seasons. And now it is the ruler of time and Heim! Heimerheim!
How did you overcome your three siblings?
'Tis easy when thou hast but to wish upon a well, and the generous pit delivereth unto thee the power of chaos. It doth whisper, the demon straight into my wintry wit, and a woman he sendeth forth into the fields of faery. The stone of stars, no more doth she ask of me. The stone and blood of imps. In return she giveth unto me this staff. My siblings enslaved within. Strong are they, these immaculates. Stronger than me. For thy wield the powers of darkest demons. And stronger than thee I am too. The lord of all the seasons. The ruler of all the elements. The one king of eternal winter.
Okay, enough of this rambling. Our battle has been a long time coming.
I, Avatar, I. Thou hast travelled far, and delveth deep into the heart of winter, but here thou shalt find thine end. Ice preserveth life and death, and in between the two, thou shalt spend the ages in frost encased!
Right, okay, let's see if I can do it as well as last time. On the last occasion that wasn't recorded, I managed to defeat him before he changed the seasons for the third time, the elements. So let's see if I can do it this time. Slow failed. Oh, immune to freezing, that's good. Oh, damn it! No! Right. Well, let's get this on straight away. Barrage. A little bit of a start there. Got a chance to hit up. And call that. Let's try spider. Where shall we put him? There. Okay. Right, we need to get rid of that frozen. Heal on Medora, ready? Because she's going to get slapped today, sir. Right, let's try a weak. Weak failed. Come on, hit it, that's the way. flurry. Ooh, yes, nice damage.
Now thou shalt have a taste, Avatar, of the cold, dead breath of Boreas!
Okay, well, okay, I'll have to hit this one with ricochet. Hope it, yes, it does ricochet. That's okay. And again. Ooh, yes. Spidey. Every little bit helps, Spidey. Thank you. What can we do? Not a lot, I don't think. Well, I can increase Medora's damage. And we can try and curse him. Weak, yes, that's good. Can that finish the ice elemental? We'll save that, we'll get Nick up. I want to get him down as quick as possible. I can't use any elements on him because it will heal him. Right, whirlwind. Good, 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 good. And encourage. Keep resisting the freezing, that's the way.
No grave contains me.
Ooh, 101. Okay, that's not too bad. Here we go. Ouch. Ouch. Good old Medora. Okay, that's not good. Might as well just finish it.
Face the unending darkness.
Okay. We got one more. Very nice. Right, let's try mute. See if we'll silence him. Nope, silence failed. Should have known better, really. Yeah, she's got one more heal left on her. Let's get Bear Daughter sorted out. There we go. We're all okay there, I think. Right, what can we do? What can we do? Not a lot. No, all the elemental stuff will heal him, so we will save her points for the heals.
Stay back, my friend.
Only one attack, right. Cripple. Cripple failed. Damn it. (sighs) 211 damage. Wow. Yes, use that.
A million tiny pieces!
Well, I've never heard her say that before.
I feel better already.
What can we do? What can we do? Not a lot, I don't think. Decaying Touch, no. Nope. You can save your points, and you can as well. Everybody's fully healed, and your elements will heal him. Ooh, yes. (sighs) 402 damage was that. Wow. Nice. Oh, let's try that, get additional damage.
We won't be hearing from you for a while.
I thought he might be immune to knockdown, but it's a little bit of extra damage there, just in case.
And
there we go, there's a second change of elements.
I call to burn thy body.
And he's not touched any of us apart from Medora, I don't think. Oh, how do I? Don't go running off. Alright, okay, we don't need anything
into
else.
Into the fray once more.
I can get rid of you now.
Seven have mercy on your soul.
And Spidey's gone, so we can get out. Skelly. And we can use that on these elementals, I think. Yes, that one gone. Thank you. And the same on you.
I conjure the spear of the winter.
Damn it.
Thing.
They dance about in those fragments and you can't target them. Right, put that on Medora. It'll heal.
A stitch in time, eh, my friends?
Oh, that's right, Medora.
What do you think, Source Hunter? Shall I start shredding from the top or the bottom?
Ooh, what? Right, come on, Skelly, you can do it. There we go. What's that one gone? And that one. There we go. Right, I'll just put a little end of save in there so I don't have to do this again if the game crashes. And there we go. Right, let's see what we've got here then. Well, first of all, we need to shift all this, don't we?
Time to get your feet wet.
It's hopping all the way to my boot soles.
A little heal on bed or two, and I think that's all we need. We can then start picking up the stuff. Yes, there we go. Let's hope it's all good stuff.
I've got my eyes on the prize.
Carrot. And the elemental stuff.
Oh, hero. Tis I, the Summer King. Holy do I... Hey, quit shoving! Knock it off, will you? I'm trying to... Excuse me.
Out of the way! It's Lurian's turn! Well, I thought the day would never come! Thanks for giving old Carrot Face the Great Melt! We in the Earth Kingdom owe you a tremendous... What? Well, you'll have to wait your turn! Oh, for the love of all that's igneous, go ahead then, if it'll stop your owling.
Okay, it would appear that the last elemental doesn't have a voice. Excuse me. How can I break you out of this stuff?
We overheard a crafty little imp named Jijix tell Boreas that the staff can only be destroyed where it was created. The elemental forge. He seemed to imply that the forge was somewhere in Iverheim itself, but I know not its exact location.
But you must always feel the breeze is stagnated in this prison, okay?
Better the crackle of embers than this idiotic blustering.
Ooh! Cover your ears, hero! Nothing whips up a flame like a wild wind!
Okay, I'll begin searching for a way to break
the
free.
The Elemental Forge, hero. It's the only way.
Okay, log updated. There we go. Eternal
Dense
Winter.
Dense and devil's brats, comrade. A talking staff? Burn it before its sauce tendrils start leeching your eye jelly. Your world is more horrifying than I ever knew.
Okay. let's join everybody up, shall we? Right. Now, in the last save, I actually went and brought the elemental staff, but since we just learned the name of the earth elemental, I think I can actually get through this gate now. Let's just clear this first.
Sudden all the way to my boot soles.
Then come over this direction. Put in a save.
You who seek the winter treasure, prove your intention, prove your worth. I demand to know if friend you be, the name of the earthen brother of Boreas.
And that was the name I was looking for, which the name is Lurian.
Correct you are.
Which removes the barrier. Right, so we'll do this bit first, I think. Just looking for any obviously that's not the right place. Where is it?
Just happened.
Oh, damn it. Come on, come on, come on. Come away, come away. I'm sure it's around there somewhere. There it is. Alright, let's see if I can remember this correctly now. Yeah. Okay, it's not you. Yeah, it must be Scarlet. Come on, come on. No, 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 it's not going to last long enough.
Intruder spied.
Right, how far we got to get? We've got any invis portions on us? Medora. They do tend to last longer, the invis portions. Nope. Nope, it would appear not, so here we go. I fail. What? Come on, how can it fail? I'll have to run like hell here. Come on, you can do it. Oh, damn it!
Intruder's bide.
There we go. Alright, get the invisible on again. Taking care of those. A little save in there just in case. Empty bottle. No, thank you. How much are they worth? Ooh, 162. Yes, please. Right. What have we got on? There's an inert stone. Get that.
Really hoping to find something better.
And where's the locket? Royal Guard Talisman. Equip. And wait. Until we get the update. Anytime now. There we go. 5,000 experience.
Something seems to have materialized in my pocket.
I'm not going to be the one to fish it out, if that's what you're asking.
And what do we get? We get the Winter Ring. One intelligence. Willpower. Yes. So, we'll put that on there. Oh, we didn't check on this stuff, did we? What's that? That to Midora, give her regeneration then. That's bobbins. Oh, that's nice. We'll equip that, I think. Send that one to Scarlet. One intelligence, one pickpocketing. We'll send that to Scarlet as well. Oh no, she's got strength. Damn it. Right, try by her daughter. 42. Yeah, it's not bad. So that's Roderick. Oh, she's got two Lore Master rings on. Alright, wait and see how we go on with that then. By her daughter. She's got dexterity, so we'll send that to Roderick. Sort that out. Right, here we go. Loot time. Light gold cup. Plate. Minor healing. Light gold cup. Painting of a woman. Sword kit. Homestead. Winter amulet. Another one. One speed. Is that better than one intelligence? Inflict frozen on contact. Let's try that. Send that to Scarlet. No, send it back. Right, okay. Right, what can we do? What can we do? Glasswear sheep. Yes, new log entry. Legend of the Weir Sheep. Okay. I've never actually done that quest, so I might actually do that this time. Identify. Alright. Take it. Well to lip. I nearly missed that then. Well teleportation scroll. So we can send McWally, whatever he's called, back. McTavish. I don't know, whatever he's called. right, okay. Secret of the scroll. Chest. Perception and sneaking, strength 9. Those are skills for a rogue. Oh, we'll take it. Could go through all those, but I'm not going to. There might be something tucked away there, but I'm sure whatever it is we can manage without. And I just took that without knowing, so we'll go into the inventory and do it from there. One dexterity, bear daughter. Come on, be something good. 81, no, it's not good. Magical tragedies. Secrets of the Scroll. No recipe. Alright, I think that's it really for this. We just do this bit.
The stone is adorned with strange runes.
Oh, use the foreign language of the fairy to decipher the runes.
You speak the words out loud and hear an inviting click nearby.
Oh, that's a first as well. I've never done that before. My daughter. That's my daughter. Two-handed, that's my daughter. My daughter. And me, I think. One bodybuilding. Yes, I'll equip that, I think. Okay, well that's something new that I'd never done before. I must have got the fairy book. Right, we need to go to... First of all, quick save. Lava pits. It's nice when you find something new that you'd never got before. I do like that about this game. You think you've gone through it and done most of the quests and got most of the loot, and you find something new, which is always nice. Right, you need a little heal on there.
My blood turns to ice within my veins.
We can do this, we can break down the elemental forge and release his siblings, and then we can go and get Ikara out of the ice. Come on, boys and girls. Elemental forge. Where is it?
Brother, sister, we are free! And who is this? Can it be that a frail mortal human faced and bested our own scheming warriors? Ah, but this is no mortal I see. Strange you'd take the guise of a source hunter. But I shall of course honor your chosen form. Indeed, I suppose I should have expected that one of your kind would snare our brother sooner or later. Boreas always did dance uncomfortably close to the dark arts. But I suppose the others of we elemental monarchs thought it better not to interfere in the affairs of his realm.
Don't you think he's got an incredible voice? I could listen to his voice all day.
No, like fools, we waited for his pride, his hunger for more and ever more power, to pull us from our own seats of safety and into his sordid storm.
I think it's very deep and nice.
We, and with us all the subjects of the realm of Faerie, do owe you our lives, Source Hunter. If, no, not if, but when, we might be of assistance to you in this dimension, you must call upon me personally.
Okay, I found the White Witch, but she's trapped in ice. Can you help me free her?
Source Hunter, it would be my sincerest honor. Take this rune, and use it to summon me when you're near the witch once more. If she can be extracted from Boreas ice, I'll find a way to make it so.
Okay, I know you are, so there's no point in asking who are you. I'll take my leave.
Whoa, that's something then, isn't it? We best be on our way then. The Spring and Autumn Kingdoms won't rule themselves, you know. May our paths cross soon, Source Hunter.
Alrighty then. Where do we need to go? Hibernheim the prison. Another little save. I don't know if anybody else is playing this on the PC that is watching this video, but I do have struggle sometimes with this game on the PC. It does tend to cause the driver to crash for some reason. I don't know what it is. It'd be interesting to know if anybody else is having the same problem with it. Right. What do we need? Need to use the crystal.
I don't know how long she'll last within that ice. There must be a way.
Where's he gone? Let's just add it. There it is. Use.
This is your White Witch, then. And you're sure you want to free her, are you? Even our mad Boreas wouldn't have wasted such precious ice on a petty criminal. Whatever she did to find herself here must have been rather severe indeed. But I am in your debt, and I would be remiss not to honor your request. Shield your eyes, Source Hunter. To melt ice of this refinement, I'll need to summon an equally rare flame.
Alrighty then. Melt that ice. Thank you.
Gods, it's colder than a witch's teat. How very callous of Leandra to inter her only sister in a barren tundra for eternity.
Ikara, you're all right? The ice, King Boreas, and your sister. What a frigid hell you've endured.
And yet not even a frigid hell like this could induce you to put on a shirt, could it, Ahu? My old friend, surely I have you to thank for my salvation.
That honor goes to a pair of talented source hunters, actually. If not for their efforts, I'd be quite uselessly prowling around your prison still.
Then perhaps I ought to address my savior directly. Source Hunter, is that the masquerade? Well, what a motley crew we are. Isn't there somewhere a bit warmer we might discuss matters?
What do you mean by masquerade?
Ah, yes, of course, of course. Do pardon me. I didn't mean to imply you were very clearly eternal beings in the guise of minor mortals. Not at all. Please, let's do carry on.
I'm not going to ask her the White Witch, because I know she's the White Witch. How did you become imprisoned here?
First things first, Source Hunter. For my freedom,
I owe you every imaginable thanks. My soul had withered in this prison, and I might not have survived much longer without your help. Now, about the culprits. My corrupted sister and the mad Winter King. When I realized exactly where and to whom Leandra was consigning me, I was certain I'd never enjoy the sun's warmth again. But neither she nor I anticipated the Source Hunter. That was her mistake, and my blessing.
I never would have imagined Leandra capable of dealing with the likes of Boreas, but she has changed into someone I hardly recognize anymore.
Oh, here we go. You stand accused of murdering the Sarcelian High Councillor, Jake. I'm really not interested.
I take no pleasure in the memory of that night. The thought of hurting anyone or anything is abhorrent to me. But in this case, I judged it necessary. If you've come this far, I trust you've learned that the Councillor was far from a humble civil servant. This doesn't excuse my behavior, but perhaps it can help to explain it.
Okay, what happened that night?
It's a sordid story, to be perfectly frank. Two sisters, a philandrous, treacherous wizard, death and mayhem. Are you sure you're interested in such things? The sparkle in your eye belies your better nature, Source Hunter. Now I know that it is your duty to get to the heart of this. And, in truth, the events of that night were but one part of a larger and much darker matter. A matter in which I'll dare to beg your assistance before we're through with one another. Now, that terrible night. One night, as I slept, I had a sudden revelation. No dream, but a vision. My sister Leandra and my lover Xandalor. I didn't understand, but I recognized their location. Cyseal's King Crab Inn. I arrived and looked through their window, but inside, everything was wrong. Leandra had fled, and Councillor Jake stood over the wizard, a knife in his hand and hate in his eyes. As I watched, he drove the dagger deep into Xandalor's heart, and I was too late to stop him. In that moment, I broke. I saw before me not a man, not even a beast, but evil incarnate. And I used Source to slay him. On the floor lay Xandalor. In my hands, I held Jake's life force. I had sworn never to use Source, but I couldn't walk away. And so I did the unthinkable. I used the Councillor's life to save Xandalor's. He was alive, but only just. Betrayal. Murder. Source. We were all of us guilty now. If you were any other Source Hunter, I suppose you'd strike me down where I stand after that terrible admission. Fortunately for us both, you are no other, Source Hunter.
All right, tell me about Leandra.
My own little sister, if you can imagine it. She was always the more ambitious, the more exacting of us. And she had no fear of the darkness that so often accompanies Source. Her collusion with King Boreas in imprisoning me here confirms my worst fears. She is planning something far greater than I could have anticipated. For this reason, and with a heavy heart, I must ask you, Source Hunter, to find out how far exactly Leandra has become entwined in the dark arts.
Okay, it's forcing me to ask you. Are you the White Witch?
Oh, yes, I suppose I am. But I do prefer my given name. Ikara, that is. Charmed. But I hope I haven't disappointed my own hero. Am I just as white and witchy as you'd hoped?
Okay, I'll take my leave.
I hate to extend my own invitation, Source Hunter, but I believe I ought to accompany you to Zigzag's hideout. Presumptuous, yes, but I'd recognize the imp's essence just about anywhere. Both he and you must learn more about the darkness that has extended itself into our dearest Rivellon. And I believe I know where we must begin.
Ah, but unless that's a bear flailing through the threads of time, I do believe Master Zigzax is on his way. Make way, Source Hunter, landing in 3, 2...
Hunters, you've done it! Ikara is free! Ah, what good it does my impish heart to see her safe and bright as ever! We have much to discuss! Come, one and all, to the end of time! A spot of something warm with the soft glow of the tapestry ought to do us all a bit of good, hmm? Ikara, now, if we're done playing hide and seek, let's not waste a jot more time! Oh, I just can't wait to pick your every synapse!
After you, Master Zigzax.
So that's the White Witch, eh? I expected someone a little more evil. I can't say I'd cut her down from a stake, but she sure has fewer horns than I expected.
Oh, if only Jarrett were here to meet her. He would have loved to lay eyes on the White Witch of so many legends.
I bet he would. Right, we have a conversation.
We've solved the murder and caught the culprit, yet this case feels anything but closed.
That's very true, yeah. There's more to this crime than simply fight. Killing a killer is hardly the same as killing an innocent, after all.
We'll have to learn more before we can assess Ikara's true guilt in this matter. Fortunately, she seems quite eager to tell us more about this entire dark affair.
That she does. Oh, romantic. Okay, off to the end of time.
There you both are. Marvelous. Your efforts have borne even more fruit. A new piece of the tapestry has been mended. The weaver's been hard at work with the thread Starstone has borne her, and a whole portion of history has been rewoven. Rejoice, my friends, rejoice! For now we witness a tale from the eons torn from time, but now, thanks to you, restored.
After the war was won, the Void Dragon remained a great threat to all existence. And so, upon the anvil of creation, the God Box was crafted. The Void was locked within, but still the question remained, who would guard the box? The two generals offered themselves. They would give up life and glory to stand sentinel. Transformed into immortal beings, they would be the Void's eternal guardians. They placed the box and the guardians in the First Garden, home of Astarte and of the world's most beautiful power, Source. For time immemorial, the Guardians stood by the God Box, no longer human in body or in mind, but duty personified.
Well, there we are. Duty personified.
So that is who we were. Demigod Guardians of the God Box. I reckon you're right. Besides, even gods can die. And from what we've seen here in this realm, little good came from being a half-divine.
Cautious. Okay, I've not had that one before either.
I salute you, my master. Other elementals lie in wait until with a word you command them to action. Which one of them, pray, has your preference?
Let's go with... What shall we go with? I don't know. Let's go with Ice and Element.
Yes, indeed.
Thy will be...
Okay. Never check these. Really? It's not like me. Right, Ice Elemental.
Oh,
first of all, there should be a book over here, I think.
I
made my very words make
you free. Quick look at that.
To the ground.
Yeah, update the log, general story. No.
By the hoary beard of Boreas, can it be? You've come. You've come home. It's about time, isn't it? Your quarters have been invaded by all manner of madness.
Who are you?
Does my brilliant frost beguile you? I am Ice, of course. A soldier of ice, to be explicit, and this is where I have dwelt across many eons. Here I wait for the day, if ever, I am called to serve the realm again.
What do you mean by calling this my home?
Could I be more explicit? This place is of your essence. Can't you feel it in your very bones, as I do in every crystal of frost within me? You belong here. And this place belongs to you. I cannot tell you why or how, but I know it to be true.
You say you have served the realm before?
Of course. Alongside my opposite, the Eternal Fire, we were summoned in service of a goal greater than the timeless battle between heat and cold. Yes, together we sought victory against the Void. You can thank our great army for all of this, you know. For existence itself. Those were times of great proportions. The forces of nothingness pitted against those of life. And naught but ourselves marching to the beat set by our great leaders could stop the Void's encroachment.
Okay, can you stream me nice?
Your home, your rules, naturally. What would you like to know?
Let's see what we've got here. Anything of any use? Barrage. Rain of Arrows, level 15. What level are we? Can't remember. I'll get that anyway. Vampiric Arrow. Ooh, we'll have some of that. Adept, and that's a master. Okay. Cleansing water, water of life, hail attack, master. Mass healing, yes. Look at the price of these. Ice wall. Mass slow. Winter blast. As master as well. Wow. Hail attack. We've got to sell anything. Not a lot. I don't think we'll use that. Okay, get rid of that. That's a bit better. Not too shabby. I'll take my leave, thank you.
To explore your abode, are you? Very good. I'm sure there's something around here that will jog your memory.
Thank you. Right. ice wall. Oh, I've got two of those. Great, okay. That's fine. Alright, let's head back. Need to get this updated and then we can call the episode once we've sorted all this out.
Why? I see Master Zigzax has upgraded from his shabby little hut at the edge of the hour, from the fairy dimension to the, space-time weaver hunter imp one. What do you call this place again?
It's our homestead on the shelter plane at the end of time.
Ha! Is that so? It seems I have my share to learn about the magical world yet. The end of time. Well, suddenly your association with Master Zigzax makes sense. Well, I must say, it's no small relief to find myself in a safe haven among such allies.
All right, let's start from the beginning. How was your sister involved in the dire happenings about Rivalon?
I believe the answer to that begins centuries ago, when your order were still cutting down so-called dark magicians by the dozen. Ours was a family of born sorcerers, you see. It was in our blood to interact with Source. But our parents were determined to curb the power within us. Still, their meekness wouldn't save them from the Source Hunters.
You mean someone of our order killed your parents?
They came on a quiet morning. My mother was wild with fright and commanded me to hide myself and Leandra outside, among the trees. Even at that young age, we knew not to question her. We climbed high into the branches of a nearby tree, and before we could look away, our parents were cut down without ceremony before our door. The Source Hunters sauntered away, wiping their blades with pride. Two more sorcerers dead, a job well done.
And what became of Leandra and yourself?
From that moment on, everything was different. As we trembled in that tree, our fear and our desperation were so potent that the magic within us began to weave together. Our souls became forged together, our bond unbreakable. We would survive, thrive even, within those woods, never speaking to outsiders. Our soul forge meant that if one of us were to die, the other would instantly perish too. We kept one another close. Leandra's capacity was enormous. Source didn't frighten her, and she delved into that dark well with terrible regularity. I did my best to guide her, but she fast outgrew my admonitions.
What happened between yourself, Leandra, and the wizard?
My sister and I were mired in a solitary existence. Witches among the trees when Xandalor came. Leandra especially couldn't leave him be. He was a feast of information, and she wouldn't rest until she'd absorbed every bit of knowledge he offered. Their days were spent on charms, hexes, and the like. At night, Leandra would wander off to practice what she'd learned, and Xandalor and I would settle into our quiet tasks, side by side. We were a content trio, the three of us, but base impulse would undo us.
What do you mean by base impulse?
As you know, Leandra and I were soul forged. This offered us a window into one another's souls. I knew Leandra had developed feelings for Xandalor, and she knew I had too. But it was me to whom he confessed his love. Those quiet evenings together had captured his heart, as they had mine. Her heart broke the moment we announced our new attachment, and I felt the pain of it as sharply as a knife. She fled, without a word, and I didn't see her for two terrible years. My connection to her, our soul forge, grew weaker. It was as though some third entity, a parasite, were atop our souls, sucking the strength from it day by day.
Then it's true you're a sorcerer. Yes, of course we know that.
But there is more to our kind than they teach at your academy. Source isn't only blood and madness. It's like lightning, an exquisite current of great power. We sorcerers are like metal steeples. Source is drawn to us and it flows through us. But what so many fail to understand is that Source can be controlled. The power drunk through history have abused it, and all the world's sorcerers have borne terrible consequences.
What consequences do you mean?
Tell me, Source Hunter. In all your hours studying the arcane arts, did your great masters ever suggest that perhaps not all sorcerers were evil? Did you ever hear, even once, that some of us were weak and gentle, that we could be simple forest folk healing the sick and frozen each winter. No. I doubt also that they'd mention that one day this hunt of yours would birth a broken soul powerful enough to inch all of Rivalon toward oblivion.
So you blame Ingles for Leandra's doings?
No. No, that would be going too far and eschewing my own responsibility. I believe Leandra's long fall down did begin at the hands of some of your own order. But it was I who sparked all of this.
Is there no redeeming your sister?
I believe that our soul forge has been damaged. By what? I can only guess. The fraying of the bond between us has left Leandra adrift in a well of sorrow she truly believes will never end. What she needs is a hand. My hand, out of this abyss. If our soul forge is repaired, I am certain she'll cease blazing this path of destruction.
What's next then? How do we stop her?
We've a single order of business first and foremost. Leandra is gathering an army, and I fear we'll have to get through it if we wish to find her. But first, we must learn more about Leandra's plans. How many of these so-called Immaculates does she have in her palm, and to what end is she directing them? Your journey must begin in the Lakula Mines, where she has been accumulating materials and manpower for a purpose as yet unknown. The way will be dangerous. Her allies are growing more powerful and numerous by the minute. But we must discover exactly what Leandra is planning and why.
Okay, what can you tell me about infiltrating the mines?
A soul forge comes with its own benefits, Source Hunter. Though our connection has weakened, I still see the occasional vision of Leandra's doings, the pangs of her deepest felt emotions, and flashes of her triumphs. One vision. I had thought it was only a nightmare, but now I see it was something much worse. Leandra is collecting materials, precisely what, I cannot say, and is hard at work shaping them into something... something sinister. Her frustrations are rivaled only by her mirth. I can see she's growing closer and closer to achieving something... something dire. You must make your way deep into the mines to see exactly what she's planning.
Okay.
I cannot condone the terrible things she's done, but I can seek to understand them. With our soul forge in such tatters, I believe Leandra is adrift in the not at all inconsiderable sorrows of our life. What's more, I sense a terrible force bearing down upon the bond between us. It is hungry, and it consumes ever more of Leandra's mind and soul. I cannot say exactly what this force might be, but I'm certain it's both driving me out and driving Leandra on. If I could only repair the forge, I'm certain she'd put a stop to this madness.
Okay, mines?
The way may be treacherous, but you must get inside. I fear my sister is doing something dreadful so far from the light of day.
Okie dokie, I'll take my leave. And we've got all the updates there, I think.
So this tapestry represents all of time. One wouldn't think time itself would include
right, folks.
So many
so while they witter on in the background, we will call it there. So the next episode looks like we're heading to Lakula Mines. Thank you very much for watching. This is Old Grey signing off.